Good morning. Today we're going to see about special machines. Actually, in this machines too, we done induction motor, synchronous generator. In previous semester, we completed DC motors, DC generators, and transformers. So now we're going to see about special machines. So these machines is going to made by the different type of machines what we done in the previous semester and previous chapters. So come the collaborative work one we done here. So we have different type of special machines we are going to see now. So we're going to see now first reluctance motor, universal motor, and stepper motor. So actually here we have some motors. So first we're going to see about the introduction about the motors. The reluctance motor, the synchronous induction motor, rotor has a salient pole and a cage so that it starts like an induction motor and run like a synchronous motor. So this is the reluctance motor. There's a combination of synchronous and induction motor. Hysteresis motor. Hysteresis produce a torque can be very tiny. Use the driver for electric clocks. Stepper motor, a special type of synchronous motor, rotates a number of degrees with each electrical pulse. So stepper motors normally can operated by the microprocessor and microcontroller. Brushless DC motor, a closed function of permanent magnet stepper motor with the electronic controllers. Universal motors, if a series DC motor has a laminated stator frame, it can run efficiently from an AC supply as well as a DC. So DC, this is a universal motor. So we have the five different type of motors we have in this chapter. So first we'll say about reluctance motor. Reluctance motor is a synchronous induction motor. The rotor has a salient pole and a cage so that it starts like an induction motor and runs like a synchronous motor. Uses soft magnetic core that is magnetized by the application of current in the stator coil. The magnet is spun by a three-phase AC motor with no rotor voltage. The gear teeth are designed to increase the magnetic flux driving the rotor while producing a symmetry that gives it the rotational acceleration. Permeability of the rotor provides a significant increase in induction power. Full solution of Faraday's law within time and velocity dependence. So this is a construction frame for the reluctance motor. Actually, to have the stator look like a synchronous motor stator, it have the cylindrical frame in that we have to slot the punching slots in your internal periphery manner. So we have symmetrical slot and teeth are there. In the slots only we have to place the three-phase coil. And rotor we are not providing any power supply. Actually, rotor have the different air gap will be there. It makes a high reluctance to low reluctance, low reluctance to high reluctance. Actually, why it is called as reluctance motor, you know? So reluctance is nothing, it is opposition of magnetic flux line. So when we have maximum magnetic flux, that place is called as an low reluctance. When we have the minimum magnetic flux, that path is called as an maximum reluctance. So the rotor will be moves between the low reluctance and the high reluctance. And this is a pictorial view of the reluctance motor. The whole setup is there. Yes, yoke will be there and power supply will be there. Stator is there, rotor is there, rotor coupled with the shaft will be there. The whole complete setup of the reluctance motor is there. And here we have the operation. So it's very easy actually. So we have to provide three phase AC supply. What will happen, the rotor RMF will be produced. So what will happen, the RMF will produce, you know, each pole the flux will be changes. So whenever the flux will be changes, the rotor will be moved from high reluctance to low reluctance path. So it will be continuously works. So for the rotor will be rotates continuously. So we got a mechanical output from the rotor itself. So this is work by high reluctance to low reluctance. So now we're going to see about universal motor. Universal motor, why it is called as universal motor? This motor will worked by AC as well as DC. Actually, it's nothing. It's very easy to construct because we already done in DC motors. What we did in the DC motor, similar construction only. The same construction is here. Actually, we have the field winding and armature is there. In field winding, we have to connect the copper coil. That field winding connect like a series field winding or a parallel shunt field winding. In armature coil, we have to connect like lap coil or wave coil. And the armature will be there. As well as with the armature, we have commutator and brush assembly will be there. So you know, we people know what is commutator. Commutator is converted to AC to DC or DC to AC because internally it need AC flux. That flux will be provided by the commutator. Yes. Here we have the universal motor, close view of universal motor. Universal motor assembly will be there. So in the universal motor assembly, we have so many parts. One is a kind of brush and a spring and brush holder, fan, commutator and armature and motor winding, motor shaft will be there as well as bearing also there. So all things are visible, and this is the operation of universal motor. Universal motor is very easy actually. What we'll do, you know, we have to provide easy support to the field winding and armature. So far it produces an magnetic flux in both winding. So when these two flux are interact each other, it experiences a force. That force is a torque. If you provide DC supply, that motor will be worked as a DC series motor. If you provide an OAC supply, it will work as a AC series motor. So both will run at the same torque. I will go for stepper motor. Stepper motor actually we will use in so many applications. Actually, stepper motors rotates at a angular displacement it will produce. But the pulsating output it will produce, when whatever input we are providing, it will produce a pulsating output. Pulsating output means the rotor will be rotated at the degree itself. For example, it will rotate 30 degree displacement. First, the rotor will move from 0 to 30 degree, it will give some delay. And 30 to 60, it gives some delay. 60 to 90, give some delay. So, slightly similar way, it will run as vice versa. In stepper motor, what will you do now? It have the coil in stator, A coil, B coil, C coil, D coil will be there. In rotor, we can use as a core as well as we can use an electromagnet or permanent magnet we can use. So whenever we are energizing the coil, A coil, B coil, C coil, D coil, depend upon the rotor will be attract. So it will attract, it will give some pulse degree outputs. So here we are not providing an input for both all the coils at the same time. We have to give the power supply to each coil simultaneously. For example, if you give the coil, A coil is energized, other three coils will be de-energized. After that, B coil is energized, other three coils will be de-energized. C coil is energized, other three coils will be de-energized. And D coil is energized, other three coils will be de-energized. So this is the way we have to provide input to the stepper motor. So for what we are doing, the stepper motor control system is very important here. So for the control system, we can made by the microprocessor, microcontroller. We have to write the program in microprocessor. So depend upon it, providing the input to the coil. So like that, it will work. So stepper motor we can use for so many things. So normally we are using in watch as well as the robotics. Robotics stepper motor is very, very important actually. Now all industries, advanced industries also we are using a stepper motor. So yeah, this is the construction of the stepper motor. So we have the coil winding on the stator is there, and the shaft and ball bearing will be there to avoid the friction, and magnet and rotor steel core will be there. Okay, so this is permanent magnet stepper motor construction. So working is nothing. We can use two types of stepper motor. One is permanent as well as electromagnet. What we mentioned in the previous two slides, it exhibits a magnetic field for longer period. Electromagnet is a temporary magnet. A coil having some number of turns, it wounds over a piece of unmagnetized iron, passing a DC current through the coil. It is described as existing the electromagnet. Yeah, here we have the offset sequence. Yeah, I said already we have to energize a coil A and A bar to A, B into B bar or B bar to A. Depend upon that, the rotor will be rotated. You see here. So the offset sequence at first is step one. The north and south pole will be placed like this. And step two, it will produce a 30 degree. Yeah, I think it's the offset sequence. It will be a 45, 90, like that. It is going. Yes. So second step, say step five itself, you see. So it will be changed, reversed actually. So again, we have to give that the opposite polarity, A coil and B coil. A, B, and A is de-energized, B is energized, and B coil and A coil is energized. Like that, if you have to give supply, we are getting 8 steps for a single revolution. The rotor will be rotated at 8 steps per single revolution. Thank you.